Do you want this effect on your cursor inside of VS Code? Let's see how we can do that. Alright everybody, welcome back to another video, and in today's video I am going to talk about how you can achieve this cool looking effect inside of VS Code. And it's not just an extension, you have to deal with a little bit more, but I'm going to make it easy for you. Let's talk about the source. So I was just scrolling through Reddit and I saw this post by someone who made this extension, not an extension but this script, which modifies the cursor a little bit, and it looks pretty cool, right? You can also check out this post. I'll put this link in the description below. Give it an upvote, give it a comment, and let's see how we can set this up in our VS Code. All right, so the first step is to go onto this post on Reddit, and what you can do is you can just open the .file repository of theirs. So if I just click on this, this is their .file repository, and this is where the script lives, and they also have mentioned the steps to do this. So first off, there's this DOM modding API. Now this is a VS Code extension. If I just open this up in a new tab, basically all this extension does is it allows you to add CSS and JavaScript, custom CSS and JavaScript inside of VS Code. Now if you didn't know already, VS Code is built with Electron, and Electron is a JavaScript framework. So VS Code is essentially a browser. If I go to help and if I just click on toggle dev tools, what you'll see is an actual DevTools window open up. So it's just HTML, CSS, JS. You can also add JS inside of here. Getting back to the point, all you need to do is just install this extension. I'm just going to copy this. I'm going to go inside of extensions and we'll search. And this is the extension. Now I already have this installed. Just click the install button and that's it. Now once that is installed, all you have to do is just go ahead and copy the trail effect dot file. Now, if you just open this index.js file, so I'm just going to open this up in a new tab again. Let's close this one. So this is all the code that will run inside of VS Code, and that will modify VS Code a little bit. Now, all I'm going to do is just copy all of this code. So let's do that real quick. Now, you have to pick a location to save this file somewhere. So inside of my C drive. Now, if you are on Linux or Mac, you might save it somewhere else. On Windows, in the C drive, all I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a new folder. I'll just call it VSC scripts. You can call it anything you want. And then go inside of that folder. Now, once the VSC scripts, this folder is created, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to right click and show more options. And I'll open this up in VS Code. And right over here, I'll just trust the authors. And I'll just create a new file. And I'm going to call this cursor.js. You can call it anything you want. Now, the code that we copied earlier, I'm just going to paste all of the code. And now is the time. So you can just change the cursor color if you want. This is where the color is stored. This is the default color. I'll keep it default for now. And then you can also modify a lot more things if you are comfortable with JavaScript. If you're not, then better not mess with all this. So hit save. And once this file is saved, let's go ahead and close this. Now going back inside of this README, what you have to do is you have to just add this setting inside of a settings.json file. So if you don't know already, our settings that we change right from VS Code are stored inside of a file, right? So if you just go ahead and open settings, you'll find this button up top that will allow you to open the JSON file. So let's click that. Now don't get scared by seeing all this code right over here. This doesn't really matter. All you have to do is just copy this code. Let's copy this and go inside of here and just paste this right over here. Now this is where you have to pass in the path of your file. So where your file lives. So right over here, what I'm going to suggest is keep the file and then triple slashes and just take this out and then just give the path to your file. So right now our file is stored inside of the C drive. Inside the C drive, we have the VSC scripts folder, and inside of that, we have the cursor.js. Let's just rename this to cursor.js. Hit save, and this points to our file. Once that is done, what you can do is just go ahead and open the command palette with Control Shift P, and you can just run reload custom CSS. Let's just reload custom CSS and JS. Hit enter. Now that will show you a pop-up that you have to restart your VS Code. Let's do that. And once it's done, you'll see this effect works. Now you'll see another pop-up when you do it. So this is how the pop-up looks like. But what you have to do is you just have to go ahead and right click in the settings in the cog icon, just tell it to don't show again so that it does not bother you again and again. Nothing has been changed inside of VS Code. We just added one script that modifies everything. Now what if you want to change the color? So right now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pick the color for this cursor. Let me just open my color picker and I'll just quickly pick this up, right? I'll just copy this. And now what you can do is you can just control click to open this file once more and just paste in the color that you copied. Let's just get this out of the way. Hit save. Now this is where you change the color, and now you want to see the changes in action. So what you can do is you can just open the Control Shift P again and then reload this one more time. So let's restart VS Code again, and you'll see that it works just fine. Now these are the recommended settings that you have to enable if you want it to look as good as this looks like. So if I just open up settings normally, first setting is the cursor style, set it to block. All this does is it makes your cursor block. So if I just go ahead and search for style or cursor style, I'll get these settings. If I change it to line, which is the default one, you'll see that this is how it looks like. It looks kind of weird, but if you're okay with it, then roll with it. But I'm going to change it to block. Next up, we have the cursor blinking, which is going to be phase. Now, if I just go ahead and search for cursor blink, what you'll see is phase. That's what I have set. But if I change it to blink, which is the default one, this is how it looks like. So basically, this is how it blinks, the cursor blinks. Last but not the least, this is the setting, which is a smooth carrot animation. Now, this is kind of important. If we go back in here, I'll just search for smooth carrot animation, and I'll just turn it off. All it does is it allows your cursor to move smoothly. Right now, if you see, the cursor moves instantaneously, but if I want to move it smoothly, I'll just make this on, and you'll see the cursor moves a lot more smoother. One more thing that I like to do is I'll just go ahead and change the color back to what it was before, and now this is how it looks like. I hope you enjoyed this video. All the links will be in the description below, and make sure to check this Reddit post again. Comment below if you have any questions, and let me know what is your point of view on this effect. It looks really cool to me, but it might be distracting to some people. So if you like it, keep it. If you don't, let me know what you think about it in the comments below. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe to the channel. Let me know in the comments if you want more videos like these, and thanks for watching.